Very happy, wasn't a bit sentimental. It may have been a great tribute. I'm sure somebody made a speech. But the people were so excited about who was going to get a prize.
In the early 20th century, women's participation in the theater was at an all-time high and caused a dramatic shift. In 1928, Antoinette Perry Farouf began her directing career, eventually leading to multiple hit plays that would inspire women and audiences for decades. Mary Antoinette Perry Farouf, who also went by Tony, was on the frontier of women in theater, creating the American Theater Wing Professional School, becoming the first successful female director, with many of her plays experiencing extreme success well into the century, and providing funds to organizations that support burgeoning young actors. In the short term, she oversaw over 1,500 stage performances, and the Tony Awards were established in her honor. In the long term, she encouraged more women to pursue careers in stage directing and continues to serve as the standard bearer for directors in the theater. There are many inspirational figures in many different fields of work during the challenging times of the 20th century. There are incredible pioneers in science, space, theater, and an immense amount of other fields. After being granted the right to vote, women played a significant role in the 20th century through protests for women's rights. Between 1900 and 1950, there are many significant events that impacted not only Antoinette's life, but also the world as a whole. World War II being a tremendous impact. The theater may not have been a huge part of the public view of the wars, but many theater programs helped boost morale of soldiers during war times. Due to America's huge increase in growth in the early 20th century, the economy skyrocketed in what was today named as the Roaring Twenties. The theater boom, also in the 20s, extremely helped the theater become more seen, helping Tony's organizations to be more successful. By the time women were able to cast their ballots, Antoinette was old enough to also vote. Women gained the right to vote on August 18, 1920, leading to women to have more say in community, school systems, and health benefits. The Great Depression, starting in October of 1929 and ending around 1939, was an extremely important event in American history. In 1931, after the stock market crashed, 6 million Americans were out of work and were looking for jobs. While the workforce was mainly dominated by men, when they started losing their jobs, women fulfilled the positions they left. The number of working women in the United States increased 24% from 10.5 million to 13 million between 1930 and 1940. Between 1929 and 1939, the marriage rate fell by 22%, which led to an increase in the number of single women looking for work. Additionally, single women protested for married women to be fired or out of the workplace because they usually already had a source of income within their homes. This helped women in the theater see the opening for them to pursue careers that men would usually fulfill, such as director positions. One inspiring but not widely known pioneer of the century was Mary Antoinette Perry Farouf. Born in 1888 in Denver, Colorado, Mary Antoinette Perry Farouf, who often went by Tony, was a huge inspiration for women in acting and broke the barrier for women in directing, creating a frontier for women in the theater. Heavily inspired by her aunt and uncle, who were both well-known actors, Tony joined their touring company at age 15. Though originally looked down upon because of her gender, Tony ended up being a huge inspiration for many women to this day through her plays and the creation of the Tony Awards. Her acting debut was in Chicago on June 26, 1905. She starred in more than 10 plays from 1906 to 1927, all plays running multiple shows in many different states. Eventually, she married Frank Farouf, who was the president of the Denver Gas and Electric Company at the time. However, when she married him, she took a break from the theater. She invested in Pemberton's production of Zona Gale's comedy, Miss Lulu Bett. It was well-liked by the public and went well in revenue, and because of this, she received her husband's blessing and she was put in his will. When he died in 1922, she inherited $13 million. After he died, she went back to acting, starring in multiple hit plays and inspiring girls across the country. In 1928, after suffering a stroke, she went into directing, which was not considered a woman's job at the time and mainly was fulfilled by men. At first, because of her gender, she was not highly liked, but because of her past experience in different roles, she became more successful the more plays she directed. Though entering a controversial job at the time, she was the first successful female director and directed more than 30 plays, which all ran for multiple performances, many being very rewarding in profit. After being considered a pioneer in acting, she blazed a trail for women in stage direction because of the immense success of her plays. Her most successful play was the Pulitzer Prize-winning comedy and drama Harvey, running for 1,775 performances. While she acted and directed, she supported countless organizations relating to the young talent in theater, women in theater, United Service Organizations, and World War II entertainment, which was unheard of at the time. Through her many performances and big acting roles, Toni was able to create immediate impacts on the theater community and open the stage direction frontier for women. When she first started her acting career, she was one of the youngest female actors in the U.S. Quickly becoming a popular actor, she gained recognition from the public. With her newfound fame, she inspired other people to pursue careers in the theater, such as Bob Fosse, Angela Lansbury, and James Earl Jones, who all also attended her school, the American Theater Wing Professional School. Through her fame and becoming more known, she was able to become a more inspirational figure of her time. Also through her creation of organizations such as the Stage Door Canteens, she boosted the morale of soldiers in the trying times of World War II. In an interview, Pemberton, a co-worker of hers, once said, "Probably about a third of her life was given to her work, the other two-thirds to helping people individually or through the organizations she headed." She made extreme efforts to make the theater community a more diverse place by helping young actors achieve their dreams in playing big roles. James Earl Jones, a biracial American actor best known for voicing Darth Vader in the Star Wars saga, was a student who attended the American Theater Wing Professional School. Going to Toni's school helped him pursue his career. In her lifetime, Toni helped with over 7,000 auditions for young actors, and she led many people to achieve their dreams, such as James Earl Jones. Toni is still honored in many ways today. In 2004, Toni was inducted into the Colorado's Women's Hall of Fame since she was born and raised in Colorado. In addition, Time magazine remembered her as one of Broadway's few successful female directors. Her biggest impact is the Toni Awards, which are televised annually to this day, being named in her honor. After she died suddenly of heart complications in 1946, a close friend and co-worker wanted to do something special in her honor. They established the Toni Awards because of her heroic work for the American theater community. Around 1,200 guests gathered for a dinner on April 6, 1947, at the Waldorf Astoria Hotel in New York City, where the first Toni Awards were given out. However, the medallions given out today did not always exist. The first awarded medallions were given out in 1949. Today, the Toni Awards are seen as the highest honor in American theater, and they serve as a testament to the long-term impact of Toni's influence on American theater and her opening the frontier of women being in charge. Against the odds of the political, social, and economic hardships of the 20th century, there were outstanding pioneers of art, science, history, and many other inventions. Women had a crucial influence in the 20th century through their activism for women's rights and being given the right to vote. Marie Antoinette Perry Farouf, Toni, was one of the century's inspirational women. Toni was able to have an immediate impact on the theater community through her actions. In trying times, she went above and beyond to improve the world and the theater community. Toni is still remembered in many different ways today as a result of what she did while she was still living. Without her actions, women today would have such greater expectations in the theater. She helped inspire lots of plays or films directed by women to this day, in some way or another. In an article, Stephanie Cambra, a female stage director, was mentioned to follow in Perry's steps. She explained that throughout the years, directing has been such a boys' club. However, at the end of the article, she mentions how a director is essentially a storyteller, and gender has nothing to do with a talent for telling stories. You can support many women in theater by watching plays that they've directed or were cast in, or donating to charities or organizations that benefit women in theater. Doing so continues the legacy of Toni and her work for blazing a trail for women in the arts.